हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन सिक्स वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ यूनिट टू दैट इज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम यू विल स्टडी टुवर्ड्स इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन एंड क्वांटम थियोरी ऑफ रेडिएशन। व्हेन एन ऑब्जेक्ट मूव्स अप एंड डाउन और वाइब्रेट कंटिन्यूअसली द एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वेव्स is transmitted by vibrating object to a distant place. For example, when a stone is thrown in a still water of a pond, a disturbance is produced at a place where the stone strikes the water. This disturbance advances outwards in the same form and reaches the edge of pond. Such a disturbance is known as mechanical wave. In short, we can say that vibrating body, oscillating body produce wave known as mechanical wave. Like when a stone is thrown in the water of a pond, the place where stone is dropped, the water get disturbed, and due to disturbance water move forward to the edge. So the disturbance which create from the place where the stone was dropped, the water get disturbed and move up to the edge. So that movement of water is due to the mechanical wave. The mechanical wave transmit only in a material medium. So remember that to the production of mechanical wave, medium is found to be required. Beside the mechanical waves, there are waves which do not require any medium for their transmission. These waves are called electromagnetic wave or electromagnetic radiation. So for the electromagnetic radiation, medium is not found to be required. Radio waves, infrared waves, visible light, X-rays, ultraviolet rays, gamma rays, etc. are various type of electromagnetic radiations. Electromagnetic radiation is generated by oscillations of a charged body in a magnetic field or of a magnet in an electric field. In other word, we may say that to the production of electromagnetic radiation, charged body is found to be oscillate in magnetic field or of a magnet in an electric field. So at that time, production of radiation is known as electromagnetic radiation. Then remember that electric wave and magnetic wave transmit perpendicular to each other, means to the right angle. Radiations or waves have electric and magnetic field associated with them and travel at right angle to these field. The following are the important characteristic of electromagnetic radiation. First one is, electromagnetic radiation consists of electric and magnetic fields that oscillate in direction perpendicular to each other and perpendicular to the direction in which the wave is traveling. Second point, all electromagnetic radiations, that is waves, travel with same velocity. The velocity of light, that is the velocity of light, which is 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Third one is, electromagnetic radiations do not require any medium, any material medium for transmission. This you already know. means for the protection of electromagnetic radiation, no need of material medium. For example, rays from the sun reach us through space, which is a non-material medium. Now, characteristics of wave motion. A wave is always characterized by following points, following characteristics. First one, wave length. The distance between two nearest crest or nearest trough is called wavelength. Wavelength is denoted by lambda and is measured in term of centimeter or angstrom or micrometer or nanometer. In other words, we may say that the distance between two nearest crest or two nearest trough is known as wavelength. Here in this graph, the upward point, this one, these are known as crest, whereas downward point, these are known as trough. This line is the line of origin. Downward direction, the maximum distance from the middle line to the downward direction and maximum distance to the middle line in upward direction is known as amplitude. So here, to indicate wavelength, we may take distance between two crest, this one, or distance between two trough. So this distance will be known as wavelength. Always we denote wavelength with lambda. The wave has two phase with different algebraic sign, plus and minus, separated by zero amplitude region called nodes. So here in this figure, this point is node, upward direction indicated with plus and downward is with the downward, upward with the plus and downward with minus. Here some units are given, which conversion one unit to another unit, like here one angstrom unit is equal to 10 per minus 10 meters or 10 per minus 8 centimeter. One micrometer is equal to 10 per minus 6 meter, or we may see this one 10 per minus 4 centimeter. Likewise, one nanometer is equal to 10 per minus 9 meter, or we may say one nanometer is equal to 10 per minus 7 centimeter. Next point is frequency. We can define frequency as the number of waves which pass through a point in 1 second is known as frequency. In other words, we may say that the number of vibrations or oscillations in 1 second is known as frequency. Frequency is denoted by symbol nu and measured in term of cycles per second, or we measure this one in hertz also. Next point is, here frequency we indicate with nu, frequency indicated with nu, and here frequency nu is inversely proportional to wavelength lambda. So we may write this one as nu is equal to C upon lambda. C upon lambda. Next point is velocity. Here, before knowing the velocity, here C is constant, this indicate the velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Now velocity. Velocity is the distance covered in 1 second by the wave. Means the maximum distance which traveled by wave in 1 second is known as velocity. Velocity is indicated with small c. All electromagnetic waves travel in same velocity, that is 3 into 10 power 10 centimeter per second. We may say this one, 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Therefore, a wave of higher frequency has a shorter wavelength, while a wave of lower frequency has longer wavelength. So, in other words, we may say that frequency nu is inversely proportional to wavelength lambda. Means if the lambda, that is wavelength, will be more, then frequency will be less, and vice versa. Now, next point is wave number. Wave number we indicate with nu bar. It can be defined as, it is the reciprocal of wavelength, that is number of wavelengths per centimeter is known as wave number. Therefore, wave number nu bar is equal to 1 upon lambda. It is expressed in per centimeter or in per meter. Next point is amplitude. The maximum distance in upward direction, that is towards crest, or in downward direction, that is towards trough, from zero line, that is origin line, is known as amplitude. It is defined as the height of crest or depth of trough of a wave is known as amplitude. Amplitude is indicated, denoted by small a. It determines the intensity of radiation. Therefore, intensity is directly proportional to square of amplitude. Node is the point of zero amplitude. Next point is time period. It can be defined, time taken by wave to complete one cycle or one vibration is known as time period. Means time taken by wave to complete one vibration or one oscillation is known as time period. So time period is indicated with capital T, that is equal to 1 upon nu. Here T is time period, nu is frequency. So in other words, we may say that time period is inversely proportional to frequency. Means if the frequency is more, time will be less. And if the frequency is less, the time period will be more. Now next topic, next point, electromagnetic spectrum. The arrangement of various types of electromagnetic radiations in order of their increasing or decreasing wavelength or frequency is known as electromagnetic spectrum. So in other words, we may say that increasing or decreasing order of electromagnetic radiation with respect to frequency or wavelength is known as electromagnetic spectrum. So here decreasing order of frequency, here the wavelength decreases in the following order, means frequency increases as. So here wavelength of radio waves, television waves are found to be, wavelength are found to be more as compared to the wavelength of microwave. Wavelength of microwave is found to be more as compared to the wavelength of infrared wave, which is more than visible rays, which is more than ultraviolet rays, which is more than wavelength of X-rays, which is more than wavelength of gamma rays, and which is more than wavelength of cosmic rays. So we may say, in other words, we may say in term of frequency also. So frequency of cosmic rays is more as compared to gamma rays, frequency of gamma rays more as compared to X-ray, frequency of ultraviolet ray more than visual ray, and the frequency of visual wave is more than infrared rays, and so on so forth. So we may arrange the electromagnetic radiation either increasing order of wavelength, decreasing order of wavelength, either the increasing order of frequency or decreasing order of frequency. There is this figure, in this figure different kind of waves are given here, left to right decreasing order of energy, also left to right decreasing order of frequency, but left to right increasing order of wavelength. So from this figure it is clear that the highest wavelength of radio waves and shortest wavelength of cosmic rays. In other words, we may say that highest frequency of cosmic rays and shortest frequency of radio waves. Here in the visible region, we able to see the things, means it is found to be sensitive to our eyes. Here the different color, wavelength of different color given, here starting from 400 nanometer and just completing at 700 nanometer. So in this range the different colors are found, which is indicated by VCVR. So here V means violet color, I means indigo color, B means blue, G means green, Y means yellow, O means orange, and R means red. So if we compare the wavelength between, starting from violet color to the red color, the wavelength of red color is highest, whereas wavelength of violet color is less. So in other words, we may say that frequency in visible region, the frequency of violet color is highest and frequency of red color is lowest. These are in this table, rays are given with respect to their wavelength and frequency. For example, cosmic rays wavelength is found to be between 0.01 to 0 angstrom unit, and frequency is found to be 3 into 10 power 20 to infinity. Similarly, in the case of gamma rays, the wavelength is found to be between 0.1 angstrom unit to the 0.01 angstrom unit, whereas frequency is 3 into 10 power 19 to the 3 into 10 power 20, and so on so forth. So here for the radio waves, if we consider radio waves, the wavelength is found to be 3 into 10 power 13 to the 3 into 10 power 9, whereas the wavelength of cosmic rays is 0.01 to 0. So if we compare the frequency also, then frequency of cosmic rays is highest. Frequency of cosmic rays is highest, that is 3 into 10 power 20 hertz, whereas the frequency of radio wave is lowest, that is 3 into 10 power 5 to the 3 into 10 power 9. So here we may say, if we compare the frequency and wavelength, then wavelength lambda is inversely proportional to frequency, or we may say frequency is inversely proportional to lambda. Now, source of electromagnetic radiation. These rays originate in the outer space and enter the Earth's surface due to their high penetration nature. Second source, gamma rays. Gamma rays are produced during the radioactive disintegration of radioactive atoms. X-rays are produced by striking of high speed electron on metal of high atomic masses. Next is ultraviolet radiations. Ultraviolet radiations produced by sun, arc lamps containing mercury vapor, xenon or hydrogen gas, and hot vacuum sparks. Next is visual radiations. Visual radiations are produced by sun, stars, arc lamps, hot filaments of tungsten in electric bulb. Our eye is sensitive only to these radiations. Means our eyes are found to be sensitive to visual radiation. Next is infrared radiation. Infrared radiation are emitted by hot bodies or incandescent object. Next is microwaves or Hertzian waves. These are produced by a spark discharge. These waves are used in telephone circuit. So remember that in telephone circuit, microwaves are found to be used. Next is radio waves. Radio waves are produced from a spark gap discharge and oscillating electric circuits. Now next topic is quantum theory of radiation. Quantum theory of radiation was given by Max Planck in 901 and further extended by Einstein in 905. The wave theory successfully explained many properties of electromagnetic radiation like reflection, refraction, diffraction, interference, polarization, etc., but fails to explain some phenomena like black body radiation, photoelectric effect, etc. So to explanation toward the black body radiation, photoelectric effect, Max Planck as well as Einstein given the postulates. The main points of quantum theory of radiation are, first one is, the hot body emits radiant energy not continuously but discontinuously in the form of small packets of energy called quantum. Second point, energy associated with each quantum is directly proportional to the frequency of radiation. Means we may say energy E is directly proportional to frequency nu, or E is equal to h nu. So here h is a constant known as Planck constant, which numerical value is found to be 6.624 into 10 power minus 27 arc second. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज द एनर्जी इमिटेड आर एब्जॉर्ब बाय अ बॉडी कैन बी आइदर वन क्वांटम आर एनी होल मल्टीपल ऑफ एच न्यू विच मे बी 2H न्यू 3H न्यू 4H न्यू एंड सो ऑन. Therefore, energy emitted or absorbed is equal to n h nu. So here n is whole number, that may be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. So on and so forth. The energy is thus quantized. In 905, Einstein pointed out that light can be supposed to consist of a stream of particle known as photon. Means, in other words, we may say that light nature is found to be particulate as well as wave. Means light made up of stream of particles. The energy of each photon of light depends on the frequency of light. That is equal to h nu. Energy is also related according to Einstein as equal to mc square. This formula is given by Einstein. Here m is the mass of photon, c is velocity of light. It was pointed out that light has wave as well as particulate characteristic, that is dual nature. So one Einstein is equal to energy of one mole quanta. So one mole is found to be equal to Avogadro number. So we may say one Einstein is equal to energy of Avogadro number of quanta, that is 6.63 × 10⁻³. Here one Einstein, that is E, is equal to n h nu. So here n, capital N, is Avogadro number. We may write this one at the place of nu, as we know that nu is equal to c upon lambda. So at the place of nu, we may write c upon lambda. Therefore, E is equal to nhc upon lambda. We may also write the different form of quantum energy like E is equal to h nu. Since nu is c by lambda, therefore we may write E is equal to hc by lambda, or we may write E equal to AHC nu bar, because we may write energy E equal to AH nu, and nu is equal to 1 upon time period. So we may write E equal to AH upon T, and here we may also write E energy is equal to hc into nu bar, because at the place of 1 upon lambda we may write nu bar also, that is wave number. Now limitation of electromagnetic waves theory. Limitation of electromagnetic wave theory. Electromagnetic wave theory successfully explain the properties of light such as interference, diffraction, but fails in explaining the following phenomena like black body radiation, photoelectric effect, line spectrum of hydrogen atom, the effect of temperature on heat capacity of solid. So note towards black body radiation. By the name it is clear that black body is perfect absorber or perfect emitter of the radiant energy, that is it can absorb and emit all frequencies. The radiations emitted by a black body is known as black body radiation. So the material which have the capacity to perfect absorber have the capacity to absorb all kind of frequency and also have the capacity to emit all kind of frequency is known as black body. If A metal of high melting point, like iron, is heated. It first become red, then yellow, and then white light. According to electromagnetic wave theory, the energy is absorbed or emitted by a body continuously. Therefore, energy of electromagnetic radiation is directly proportional to intensity. However, it is independent of the frequency and wavelength of radiation. So we may say, thus, according to the electromagnetic wave theory, a body should emit the radiation of same wavelength, that is color, on heating at different temperature. However, frequency of emitted radiation changes with the temperature of the body. At a given temperature, intensity of emitted radiation increases with decrease with wavelength and approaches a maximum at a particular wavelength, and further start decreasing with decrease of wavelength. So here in this graph, at x-axis wavelength is taken and y-axis intensity. So here temperature T1 is less than temperature T2. So here at temperature T1, that is at the less temperature, intensity is less, whereas when we increase the temperature, the maximum, that is the intensity here, is found to be increased. Means intensity is directly proportional to the temperature. Means when the temperature is found to be increased, the intensity of radiation is also found to be increased. Accumulation of black body radiation. When a metal of high melting point is heated, its atoms vibrate and emit the radiation of frequency nu. Frequency of emitted radiation increases on further heating the body. Further heating the body means we can say the intensity, frequency of emitted radiation increase when heat is found to be increased. The color of emitted radiation changes in following order. So first of all, on heating the material, it becomes red, then yellow, and then blue. Here increasing frequency. When the material is found to be heated, the frequency is found to be increased, and due to increase in frequency, the color is also found to be changed. Thank you.